Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is your 10th Legion co-main event of the evening. Scheduled for 3 rounds of action, it is for the 10th Legion British Featherweight Championship. Sponsored by Fracture MMA. Make sure to pick up some Fracture MMA apparel. Introducing first, fighting to my left out of the blue corner. This man stands in at 5 feet 9 inches tall. Official weight, 66 kilos. Professional record, a veteran of 10 bouts. He has a record that includes 6 wins against 4 defeats. Representing Gladiator Combat, he joins us tonight from Glasgow, Scotland. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome David Gladiator Galbraith. And his adversary across the cage to my right, fighting out of the red corner. He stands in at 5 feet 10 inches tall. Official weight, 67 kilos. Professional record, 3 wins against a single blemish. Representing the Fight Ministry, he joins us from right here in Hull. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Louis Chapman. And our friend in charge is Craig Lawrence.
Leggings, and instead long pants, and instead he had to change to trunks, which he was given to 10th Legion trunks. Not allowed to wear long pants. Louis Chapman out of the red corner wearing the white and black, wearing the camouflage 10th Legion trunks is David Galbraith. Here we go, buckle your seatbelts. This one's for the British Featherweight Championship. Louis Chapman wants to show off his newfound skills, and he's coming out a man just so focused and dedicated. Louis Chapman just celebrated his 25th birthday 1 week ago, and he told me yesterday that he wants to give himself a present. That present is the 10th Legion British Featherweight Championship. Last time, you know, Louis Chapman fought was in the month of June. He lost to Lawrence Fitzpatrick, which was 9 months ago via TKO because of a cut in the first round. He decided to take some time off to learn, to grow, and to reassess. He wanted to get better on his grappling and his striking and everything. And what a takedown. There we're seeing it. But David Galbraith, though, looking for an inverted triangle. David Galbraith, 26 years of age. He's been a veteran for 6 years. He's fought a lot of top fighters. Has over 20 kickboxing fights. He's on a 3-fight win streak. Wants to make it 4. As he knows, he's in the backyard of Louis Chapman. You know, Louis Chapman was so down on himself and was so discouraged after his loss to Lawrence Fitzpatrick that he decided to take, oh my, he has a guillotine choke, but he just props himself right back up. He decided to go to American Top Team in Naples, Florida, and he worked with Marcelo Pierro, a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion who most notably comes from the Nova Unau team, which has helped out the likes of Jose Aldo, UFC featherweight champion, and a host of others. So when you learn under Marcelo Pierro, you can only get better. And Louis Chapman, coupled with the fighters that he trains with and his team at the Fight Ministry Hull, I mean, he has just grown leaps and bounds, and you can tell that his conditioning's a lot better, and he turns it around. Louis Chapman, also a former 10th Legion British semi-pro welterweight champion. It's interesting in how he went from being a welterweight, now he's dropped down to featherweight. It has been a gradual decline for Louis Chapman, but might I say that this is the best in shape I've ever seen him. But David Galbraith, though, is barreling in, looking for a fight. You know, Galbraith told me yesterday, he knows he's coming in to hostile territory, but he loves that. He wants to leave no stone unturned, and in his mind, the experience that he has of 10 pro fights, 6 years of experience in fighting MMA, that it's gonna be huge. He wants to take Louis Chapman into deep waters. And he feels that Chapman hasn't been into deep waters. What a takedown, though, for the 25-year-old native from home. Chapman staying very close to the body. You know, David Galbraith and his 10 professional bouts and even his amateur and semi-pro career has never been tapped out. He's never tapped out. Now you can hear the coaches from Louis Chapman telling him to pass. It's in half guard is Louis Chapman. Now Louis Chapman, the one thing, you know, as we had a good conversation yesterday leading up to the fight in our fighter meetings, you know, he stressed to me, you know, over and over and over again that he wants to dictate and dominate. Dictate and dominate is what he wants to do from here on out. He's 25 years of age. He believes that now he's in the peak of his career and he wants more gold. He wants to show everybody that he is a worthy champion. And it starts tonight with David Galbraith. And listen to the chants of Louis here at the sold-out Bonus Arena here at home. 10th Legion, 10 Temple of Titans. Louis Chapman in the half guard of David Galbraith. Now he's just posturing up and he's landed some ground and pound. Here's David Louis Chapman. You know, Louis Chapman, one thing that he did do, and he's done a good amount and, you know, kind of taking some time off, training with Marcelo Piero down at American Top Team in Naples, Florida. He's actually headed back to American Top Team, where he will train there in the month of May. But he quit his job. I mean, he had a job full-time as an electrician, but he decided to walk away from that to dedicate his entire life to training and fighting. And he passes the full mount. And now look at Louis Chapman. He wants to finish David Galbraith. 10 seconds to go. Will Craig Lawrence stop it, or will David Galbraith? And this one's over. Just as the horn sounds, the fight is over. And David Galbraith is livid as he throws his mouthpiece at Craig Lawrence. What a win for Louis Chapman, who is the new 10th Legion British Featherweight Champion. But David Galbraith feels slighted. Let's take a look at the replay here as we go ahead and bring it up. Louis Chapman raining down some ground and pound, throwing bounds with rights and lefts. And as we see here, Craig Lawrence steps in to wave it off, and it seemed like the horn sounded right after that. So just in the nick of time for Louis Chapman, and he improves the 4-1 and is the new 10th Legion British Featherweight Champion.
As Louis Chapman did not win the fight, the horn sounded right in the nick of time. This fight continues round two.
Well, not so fast as this fight continues. I thought it was over. I thought it was done. I thought you could put the kibosh on the hopes of David Galbraith to become the 10th Legion British Featherweight Champion. But apparently, cooler has prevailed. And this fight continues. Boy, what a lucky break for David Galbraith. He thought he lost. I thought he lost. This sold-out Bonus Arena thought he lost. I have to look at the tape one more time, but Chapman now comes in. If you're Louis Chapman, though, how does that affect your mindset? I mean, he's coming out, though, and he is not slowing down one single bit. Louis Chapman has not lost the beat. He looks better. He looks more refined. His striking looks crisp. And a left hand that lands. A left hook. Backpedaling is David Galbraith. But now if you're David Galbraith, you have gotten an opportunity. You're back in this fight. He's got to bring the fight right now at this very moment. Galbraith is a warrior. You know, he fought. The last time he was inside the cage was February 11th. He won by Kimura over Mark Cotridge. Well-rounded fighter. And actually, if you look at, he has a haircut. He has one of his sponsors put into his hair. As Louis Chapman now wants to put some right hands to the head into the temple of David Galbraith. Galbraith and Louis Chapman, some dirty boxing as Chapman pushes him off. A right hand that misses for Chapman. Coming forward, though, is Galbraith. Galbraith going backwards. Chapman starting to get to the 26-year-old from Glasgow. Chapman going backwards, using some brilliant counterpunching. Louis Chapman, excellent counterpunching, bringing the fight. Oh, another one that barely misses. Galbraith is coming in, putting his head down. He's swinging wildly. But don't count David Galbraith out of a fight. Five of his six wins have come via TKO. Galbraith can still live up to his prediction yesterday. Claimed he was going to win via second round. And now dropping down levels, looking for a takedown. Louis Chapman pulls him and he puts him. He gets the double leg. The fans clapping, showing their appreciation for Louis Chapman. Chapman wants to add more gold to his wall. Yo, all my years, this is my third year here in the UK with 10th Legion. And it's been an amazing ride, but I've watched Louis Chapman grow right before my very eyes. I remember when he fought a war with Jake Terror about 2 years ago. And he has grown every single fight. Win or lose, Louis Chapman always gets better. And now he's just teeing off. He is pounding away on the side of the head. And now he's looking for a... He's looking for a full mount, and he gets it. Before we go any further, though, I have to give credit to Craig Lawrence, renowned official from M1 Global, and also here a 10th Legion staple. But now Louis Chapman, he didn't get his TKO in round one. Now he is looking to get it in round number two. But Galbraith is staying in this fight. No one can question the heart of David Gladiator Galbraith. He came out with the gladiator mask and he knew he was going into war, but right now Louis Chapman wants the finish. He's looking to end this three-fight win streak that David Galbraith possesses. And now he's in full mount. This is just bad for Galbraith. He is being unloaded upon. Louis Chapman inflicting some damage and punishment. This is bad. Craig Lawrence ready to step in. Will Louis Chapman finally finish David Galbraith? And yes, that is the finish. Louis Chapman, it took him an extra round, but lo and behold, he becomes the 10th Legion Featherweight Champion, the British Featherweight Champion. Right now, let's bring up the replay. Here we see Louis Chapman at full mount, and he's unloading rights and lefts and just battering the face of David Galbraith. Here we see Craig Lawrence stepping in to stop this fight as Louis Chapman is the new 10th Legion British Featherweight Champion. He celebrates in victory. Louis Chapman improves to 4-1.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 4 minutes 11 seconds of the second round. Referee Craig Lawrence waves off this contest for your winner by technical knockout. And the new 10th Legion British Featherweight Champion, Louis Chapman! Louis, congratulations on the win. You look very impressive here tonight. You improved to 4-1. What a performance here tonight. You defeat David Galbraith. How sweet is this win?
Well, it's a step in the right direction. Obviously, I couldn't do it without my coaches, Neil Off, Sandy Powell. Met a lot of guys from Owen, all guys at St. Paul's. It's their hard work that makes me be able to come and do this.
Now, Louis, at the end of the first round, it looked like you had won the fight, but apparently the horn sounded. You didn't get rattled, you didn't get out of your game plan, and instead you finished the fight in the second round. Tell us, you didn't get down in that, and what was, you know, coming into the second round, you didn't miss a beat.
No, well, that's because I want to, and I believe I'm going to be number one. So I'm training like a champion, and I plan to be a champion.
How big was this win for you, and what's next for Louis Chapman?
Well, hopefully I'll be fighting May the 13th at London if Alan wants me. What's next for me is some cheese kicks. I'm fucking starving. That's about it, really.
Congratulations, Louis. That's the best I've ever seen you. You add more hardware to your collection.
Yeah, thanks for all the support, guys. Thanks to all my sponsors and everyone who's supported me so far.
Louis Chapman, the 10th Legion British Featherweight